Lauren, welcome back to my channel, and if you are new here, welcome. Today's video I am really excited to be filming because we are going to be talking about my 10 personal tips on how to afford to travel if you are a broke college student. So while I am no longer in college, at one point I was doing my undergraduate studies and I was able to visit a ton of places. I went to New Mexico, New York City, I also went to the Bahamas, I went to Florida a bunch of times, and today I'm just going to be letting you guys in on some personal secrets on how I was able to afford to travel so much and so often. So I have 10 tips here for you guys. I have them written out on my phone and we are just going to go through them and hopefully you guys can learn something from this. This video was actually requested by one of my friends. Shout out to Gabby, this one's for you. So getting into probably my biggest tip on how to be able to afford travel is to save more money than you spend. Now, most of these tips are only going to be applying to people who have a job and have their own money. If you're able to travel with your parents' money, kudos to you. I was not. So this is going to be for people who are working in college, and my big tip is to save more than you spend. I know that can be hard if you are paying your own bills, if you have student loans and are paying those. I totally understand, but even if you're able to put away $20 into your savings for travel, like, everything helps. Every paycheck, make sure you're saving, ideally more than you're spending, but if you can't do that, just save a little bit. Have a goal that you're working towards. Plan a trip in your head and, you know, imagine yourself being there and work towards that. And the biggest goal for that is to be saving your money. So definitely recommend saving if you can, because you don't want to put yourself into debt over travel. I love to travel, but it's never worth putting yourself into debt over. So definitely save up for your trips. The next travel tip that I have for you guys is to stay in an Airbnb versus a hotel. Now, 99% of the time, Airbnbs are going to be more cheap than a hotel. And honestly, I like them a little bit better. Granted, with an Airbnb, you don't get like housekeeping and stuff like that, but you get your own place. You can do a shared room in someone's apartment or something, but I like to get my own little condo. And especially if you're traveling with other people, they are so inexpensive. You can get like an entire house for $100 a night in some places versus a small hotel room for upwards of $400 or $500 a night. So definitely recommend Airbnb 100%. I will have an Airbnb promo code in the description box for you guys to use for your next travels. Also, on the note of Airbnb, I originally thought that Airbnb was only for booking places to stay, but it's actually not. They have a ton of cheap excursions and events that you can book through there. I will link down below my Miami vlogs. When me and my friend Bailey went on our spring break, we did a yacht tour that we actually booked through Airbnb. So if you're looking for fun things to do, definitely check out Airbnb for that as well. My third travel tip is to travel in a group if possible. This one's kind of self-explanatory. The more people you're traveling with, you can split the cost with more people and things will be more cheaper for you. And obviously it's super fun to travel with your friends. So if you're able to get a big group together, book an Airbnb, go somewhere fun, I definitely recommend traveling with more people rather than one or two. The fourth travel tip that I have for you guys comes to booking flights. I can do a whole separate video on booking cheap flights, but my main tip is to use Google Flights. Now, if you go on Google Flights, I think I'm gonna have like a little screen recording here or a screenshot or something. You can punch in where you're going and like your ideal dates that you wanna go, and it'll pull up a calendar and it goes through every airline that flies to wherever your destination is and gives you each day where the cheapest flights are. So if your days are flexible, Google Flights is huge for booking travel. I do it all the time. It shows you the cheapest airline and on the cheapest day. So definitely check out Google Flights rather than just going straight to like Southwest or JetBlue to book your flight on a certain day. Try to be flexible with your travel days too, if possible. And going along with being flexible with your travel days, try to avoid flying on Fridays and Sundays. Those are the biggest travel days, especially Sundays, and airlines jack up the prices of flights, especially like during spring break. Super expensive to fly on those days. So try to fly on like a Tuesday or Wednesday. That will definitely save you money for sure. My next tip is that with some airlines, you do have to pay to check a bag, and I would try to avoid this if possible and pack your stuff in a carry-on. Obviously, this isn't feasible for every trip that you go on, especially if you're going for a long period of time, but I would say don't waste the money paying $50 to check a bag if you don't have to. At least try to pack a carry-on first, and then worst comes to worst, you could pay to check the bag, but try to avoid that. My next tip is something small, but bring a reusable water bottle with you, especially to the airport. There is nothing worse than paying like $5 or $6 for a bottle of water. I think that's so ridiculous. So if you bring a reusable bottle and it's empty when you go through security, that's totally fine. Then you can just refill the water at the airport and carry it with you throughout your trip so you don't have to be spending money on water bottles, because little things like that add up while you're traveling. My next tip is something that isn't going to work for everyone, but it works for me. I think you need to have a lot of self-control to be able to do this, but it is to sign up for an airline credit card. Now, I signed up for a credit card with Southwest, and with that credit card, you get points. I believe it's 2 points for every dollar that you spend, and the more points you get, you can pay for flights in points, you can get free flights. If you rack up a certain amount, you can get a companion pass also, so you can fly and have someone come with you for free for an entire year. And the Southwest card can't only be used on travel, you can use it literally anywhere. So, you know, paying for gas, paying for groceries, you rack up points doing that. So that's how I'm able to get a lot of my flights for very cheap, if not free. So if you have the self-control and are able to pay off a credit card, definitely start using an airline credit card for most of your daily expenses. Like I said, if you're able to pay it off, that way you can rack up the points and get the benefits from the airline. And also, the airlines offer like perks on hotels and rental cars and things to do. So I would definitely consider signing up for an airline credit card. Again, if you have the self-control, because travel is not worth going into debt for. Never. Mm-mm. We don't like debt on this channel. If you guys want me to make a separate video on how to stay out of debt, how to pay off your debt, leave a comment down below. I will be happy to do that for you guys. The next tip kind of goes along more with international travel, but you can also do it if you're traveling within your country, and that would be to research the transportation options that are available to you before you get to the destination. I know most often in the US, like Uber is the cheapest way of traveling versus like a cab or like a train, something like that. But especially when you go overseas, research, you know, there's Uber, there's cabs, there's public transportation. You want to be able to research that so that you don't go and spend $80 on a cab when you could get a $10 bus ticket kind of thing. So definitely make sure to research your transportation options. And that goes for anything with traveling. Definitely do your research before you get there. Also, when it comes to events and things to do, if you just type in your destination and then free things to do this weekend, Google will create a calendar that has everything going on in the city or the country that you're going to. And you can find a ton of free entertainment that way. That's what I like to do, because why would I pay to do something when I can do something else for free kind of thing? So definitely do your research. And my last tip is probably something that a lot of you don't know. When I travel, I often look at the flights multiple times throughout the week before I actually book the flight. And what I didn't know is that airlines actually track that. They see how often you look for the flight, and then they jack up the price of it. So my tip for you guys is, if you are searching for a flight, to do it in incognito mode. You can open an incognito browser window, and that way the airline is not able to track how often you've looked for the flight, and that way they won't inflate the price for you guys. So that's another way to get cheap flights, just so you guys know. All right, guys, so those were my 10, I believe it was around 10, hacks for how to afford to travel in college. I hope that this was informative for you guys. I hope it was somewhat helpful. If you learned anything from this video, make sure to give it a like. And if you aren't subscribed yet, make sure to hit the little button. I believe it's down here. And if you have any more video idea requests, especially related to like travel and money and all of those things, I'd be happy to film them for you guys. So make sure to leave a comment down below. And I will see you all in my next video. Bye.